Sometimes the relationship between people and nature is just outside our view, and when we look for it, we're amazed to find that it has been there all along. There is a force that threads through our civilized world and binds us to our surroundings. It provides an insight that can be gained nowhere else. Rarely does this connection with nature come to us. To find it, we must search. In the everyday parts of our lives, we are reminded of wisdoms held for our asking. And if we approach it, nature's truth will come to meet us. In many different walks of life, there are people who have come to embrace nature, and from this have their own unique experiences to share. There are those whose special role is to help out their wildlife friends in need. Others, in the heart of the city, are asked to become the eyes of the river. And in the most roundabout way, those who follow stories and come to learn about themselves. My work as a documentary filmmaker for over 20 years gave me a gift. Not only to experience beauty around the world, but to see through other people's eyes. I began to recognize that nature's power is a mystery. It affects us all individually in very different ways. I set out to explore the reasons why people need to connect with nature. I was to find that there are many unique stories out there, all with a common thread. Every morning, less than a minute from the traffic heading to work at Cape Canaveral, Merritt Island National Wildlife Refuge wakes up. There's no season like spring, and perhaps no place like Florida, to witness the ritual of breakfast. It's not supposed to be easy to get up close to the wild world. Sometimes it happens by luck, though not always the good kind. For the birds that fish the piers in Florida's Pinellas County, there's one woman who can turn bad luck around for the better.
Each and every one of us has to have something that we can do and be successful at to feel good about ourselves. And working with nature and dealing with people, helping out and saving lives gives you that opportunity to do that.
What we're doing is looking for any birds out here that have fishing line connected to any part of their body, and we hope to perhaps catch one.
See that one that just landed?
Yes.
Charlene Mason has lived in Florida since she was 13.
He's okay, he's clean.
A school teacher for 21 years, she retired to become a full-time rescue volunteer at the Suncoast Seabird Sanctuary in the town of Indian Shores, Florida.
My husband and I used to take two-mile walks along the beach, and we noticed that there were injured birds on the beach, pelicans, cormorants, laughing gulls, all types of gulls, with fishing hooks coming out of their mouths, the broken wings, limping. And we knew that there was a problem that needed to be solved, that these animals needed help, they needed care.
On call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, Charlene collects not only injured animals, but friendships and the learnings that come with every rescue.
Hello. What? I just called Florida Highway Patrol and they don't know when they can get an officer there. They've got wrecks all over the place. But I soon found out as a rescue volunteer that we rescue people also. People are very involved emotionally with the animals. They want help right away, and they realize they can't do it themselves, and they call us for that assistance. So by taking care of the animals' problems, we also take care of the people's concerns.
Go ahead, Brandon. Run.
My first reaction is to hurry up and get to the bird. Very often that bird will snap that line and fly off of that fishing line and end up in the mangroves at night, strung out, strung up, and end up starving.
Everybody got a hoop net? Hoop net. Your job is to hang on to it.
Okay.
If he taps it, he taps it.
All right.
Don't let him get wrapped up right in the middle. The fisherman has every right to be here to catch the fish to eat, and there is a connection there. And the birds are attracted to the same area, and that's where the problem lies, that these birds and people get together, and usually it's the bird that ends up the loser at the other end. However, there are a lot of conscientious fishermen that know what to do if the bird is hooked.
I don't want to drop the
wheel. Heck with it, we're going over.
Just something, whether I've been sick or if I'm tired, I can still get up in the middle of the night if I get a call and go, because the animal's life is at stake. If I don't do this, somebody, some animal, some bird is going to die. So that keeps you going. It gives you the extra strength to carry on and keep doing this.
Free and clear.
Keep going, Brendan.
Would I be able to go soon sometime?
Probably not in the hospital. No, that's because it's an intensive care for birds. But you can call and ask on how he's doing.
All right.
But I can assure you he'll be okay. So thank you all again.
On days when we release the birds, and I look back into that bird's eyes, and he's looking back at me, what I get out of that is knowing that that creature is going to be free, he's flying, he's living, he's diving or he's eating. And for me, it gives me the feeling of contentment and satisfaction and reward for the effort I went to get that bird. And it is wonderful. It's like going back to self-esteem, how you feel about yourself, because you are giving. You're not taking, you're giving. And you are, as while you are giving and not taking, you really are receiving more than you would ever imagine.